Is there anybody out there from Pittsburgh?
Right here!
Hey!
Hey. I knew there had to be a few people from Pittsburgh. My name is Richie Merritt, and I'm from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Born in Pittsburgh, raised outside of Pittsburgh. You probably know why, but I'm not going to tell you. But anyway, Pittsburgh was one of the places that started doo-wop. Back in 1948. Great year. Before your time.
Is the red light on?
Yes. 1948, there was a gentleman from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania called Porky Chenwick.
Platypus and Papa.
Platypus and Papa, you're right. He was on a radio station. And he was the first one that started playing R&B, we called it back then. R&B and soul music and jazz and blues. And he kept on playing it. Nobody else was playing his stuff. They were sending people to him. They were sending records to him, trying to get him to play the music. And he would play it for everybody all over the country. Nobody would play it but Porky made sure that the world heard what was going on. So as time went on, everybody starts listening to it. Some would sneak and listen to it. Some would go to somebody else's house and listen to it. Because our parents didn't allow us to listen to it. You know what I mean? My parents didn't allow me to listen to it. You know, I came up from a Pentecostal church, man. I wasn't allowed to listen to nothing but gospel, man. I wasn't allowed to listen to Satan music, you know? I wasn't any good, man. But you know, I snuck out and heard all the songs from different people. We had a good time. I was hanging out with different guys. We were singing on the corner, doing what they called R&B. Alan Freed started that R&B circuit thing. But what happened in 1961 was the first time that the word doo-wop hit the paper. The word doo-wop didn't hit the paper until 1961. A lot of people don't know that. But if you talk to so many old guys today, they'll tell you, don't call me a doo-wop singer, man, I'm a soul singer. Don't call me doo-wop, man. I'm a rhythm and blues singer. You know, because they started in the early 40s and 50s and 60s. But you know, back in 1850 in Pittsburgh, there was a guy that put out this song called Camptown Races. Anybody know that song? Camptown Races. How does it go? You got it. So I started off with doo-dah, not doo-wop. So that's where it came from. It went to doo-dah, to blow harmony, doo-bop, doo-boo, doo-bam, doo-doo-doo-bam, dim-boop-bop, boo-beep-doo. That was the jazz, right? That was the jazz version. But you know, that's what was going on way before doo-wop, before they even called it doo-wop. You know, so what happened was, and for those of you that don't know, the word doo-wop came from these guys saying doo-wop, doo-wop, and doo-bop, and doo-wop, because they were making sounds that the trumpet and horn musicians was doing in the big bands. And we didn't have any big bands, and we didn't have any horns. So we were actually doing the horn parts. Bop, doo, ba-doo-wop, bip, dop, shoop, doo. Well, you don't know about it. But anyway, that's how doo-wop came about. For those of you that don't know, a lot of you guys know that. I know you do, because you told me this, and this is how I found out, Costa. I'm not that old either. Don't start that stuff, man. Yeah, but there was this one guy that was sending records to Porky, because he couldn't get nothing played on the radio. And he really liked this guy named Jimmy Scott. Do anybody know who Jimmy Scott is?
Yes.
You know who Jimmy Scott is? Or there was this guy that copied Jimmy Scott. And You might know who he is. Let's see if they know who he is, Jeff. His name was Little Anthony. And he copied Jimmy's slap. He did.
You don't remember me, but I remember you. It was not so long ago.